This video is going to go through the equilibrium expression and constant. It's called the mass action equation. K equals the concentration of the products over the concentration of the reactants. One of the things you have to know, you have to exclude solids and pure liquids. I'll go over that when we get to some examples. Here's a typical reaction. What you do is you take the concentration of, let's say, here's our products, elements C and D. Element C, the concentration of, and you're going to raise it to the coefficient. The power is going to be the coefficient. So let's say there's a 3 for the lowercase d to the third power. And then the reactants would be in the denominator. The coefficients would be their power. So let's go over a few of these. Here's an example. You have 3 moles of oxygen forming 2 moles of ozone. So we're going to do products over reactants. So we put our brackets in. We put our O3, which is our product, and that 2 is our exponent. And then we go to our reactant, O2, and we're going to cube that. And that's how you write your equilibrium expression. Now, this is the Haber process, nitrogen reacting with 3 moles of hydrogen to make ammonia. So let's do products over reactants. So our ammonia is on top. We put brackets there, and we're going to put the second power because of the 2. And then we're going to do the nitrogen and 2. To the first power, we don't have to write that, and H2 to the third power. Okay, now those were gases. So all the, species in the reaction have to be included. Now remember, we exclude solids and pure liquids. Well, this reaction right here, which is a single replacement redox reaction, we have solids involved. So what we're going to do, we're going to exclude the solids. So products. See the Ag solid? That's gone. So we don't have to write that. We do have to write the copper 2 ion. And that's the first power. And on the reactant side, we have copper, so we don't use that because it's a solid. But we do have the Ag plus. I'm going to raise that to the second power. And then we have the decomposition of calcium carbonate to calcium oxide and oxygen. So we'll look at this. Look, solid, solid. Gas. So the only one we have to worry about for this equilibrium expression is O2, and we throw that in brackets, the first power, and that's it. K equals the concentration of O2. Now, when it comes to K, the general rule of thumb, since it's products over reactants, if K is a number greater than 1, generally we're going to say it favors the products, or the equilibrium lies to the right because, well, the products are on the right. If the number is less than 1, we're going to say it favors the reactants or the equilibrium lies to the left. But that's general. It also has to do with how the exponent's set up and everything. But that's your equilibrium expression and how the constant works. Hope that helped.